that we start recording for some other students also. How do we start doing it? First, what is the first rule that we have to follow?
We should assume potential.
A and B potential. This boy is saying I can take reference. That also we can do. 0 and 4. That also we can do. Or otherwise, I will put the numbers A and B. This is connected up to this. And it is not connected because of this representation. There's a curve here. Means these two wires are not connected with each other. So the one which is connected up to this point, that will have same potential. So up to this point, it is A only.
Okay.
Similarly, in the other wire also, other diagonal wire, what will be potential up to the other corner?
B
only. Now we notice that this top horizontal resistance has VA minus VB potential difference. The bottom horizontal, VB minus VA or VA minus VB, this VA minus VB, this VA minus VB, all are same only. It means I can make the equivalent diagram.
All are in parallel.
As all are in parallel. And if somebody asks me to find net resistance I, then that answer is too easy to find. If somebody asks net resistance or somebody asks net current, that part is very simple.
1/2.
4 volt. Net current is very simple. Net current comes out to be 4 upon net resistance. Net resistance will be 2/4. So it is coming out to be 8 ampere current. But this is still slightly difficult to find out. Not difficult, in fact, what I should say. But you should be careful that I1, how to find out I1? Just by using a KCL here. If I use KCL here, we can get I1. How to get I1 now? I know that current from A to B will be high potential to low potential this side, right? What will be current in every branch? Each branch has current from A to B. Remember, each branch has current from A to B. So make the current A to B. And what is the value of current A to B? Let us call each branch current as I0. I0 is equal to 4/2. That is equal to 2 amperes. So this is 2 ampere current. 2 ampere. 2 ampere. Here also 2 ampere. Now we can use KCL in this place. What is the current entering? Net current is entering. And how many leaving? 1, 2, 3 branches will carry the current outwards. So I can say KCL at which node?
A,
actually, there are many A's here. So I think I should call by another number also. Mm-hmm. Maybe A1. Let me call it as A1. KCL at A1 node. So what is KCL at A1 node? That will give us current entering I is equal to 2 plus 2 plus I1. I entering I is equal to 8. 8 is equal to 2 plus 2 plus I1. So what is I1?
4 ampere.
4 ampere. So I1 is equal to 4 ampere. Similarly, what is I2? I2 you can do in the same way by, I think 4 only, right? 4 or minus 4? We have to check. I'm applying at B1 now. KCL at B1. What is the current entering in this? Current entering is 2 and 2.
That's a minus
2
4.
Plus 2 is entering. What is leaving? Leaving is I plus I2. What is I? 8. 8 plus I2 is equal to 2 plus 2. So what is I2?
Minus 4.
Minus 4. Means the direction which I have taken for this is wrong. Actually, it will be coming this side. It will be coming from B to B1, not B1 to B. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So have you understood this now properly?
Yes, sir.
Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
So now I want to modify the same question by giving this batteries in between. Let me give batteries in between. How should I give this? Maybe. So this is the case now, and here we have, what is it? 4 volt again, same situation, and A and B, this is A only, this is B only, resistances are 2 each as before, but now we have additionally batteries of 2 volt. And now I'm asking the same question. What is I1 and what is I2? How to do now? Now it will appear to be very complicated to some students. Some students will think, oh my God, not only resistance, there is battery zero, also. Huh?
Net EMF is zero, sir, due to the batteries. How not including zero? 4 volts.
Not including 4 volt net EMF in the closed loop here, it is zero. That's what you are saying, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us check once whether it is right or not. So first of all, R, as usual, as before. Out of these, how many batteries are having positive terminal towards A?
Two, sir.
Positive terminal towards A. There are two batteries having their positive terminal towards A. And there is one battery having, two batteries having negative terminal towards A. So how to draw the equivalent diagram? Two batteries towards A and with positive terminal towards A, and two batteries with negative terminal towards A. That is the equivalent diagram. And 4 volt will be this way here. What is the net EMF of this? Net EMF of this will become?
Zero, sir.
I think if you know the formula, then you know how I told you. For which I want to find net EMF?
Sigma E by R.
I want to find net EMF of these four. For these four, I want to find the net EMF. Okay. So now tell me, what is net EMF of these four?
Sigma E by R.
Sigma?
E by R.
EI by RI is equal to E effective divided by R effective. R effective is nothing but parallel combination of all these. Which will be R by 4.
1 by 2.
2 by 4 and E net. What is this here? 2 by 2
zeros.
Plus 2 by 2 minus 2 by 2 minus 2 by 2. Why minus?
2 by 2.
Because the two are having same direction, but other two are having different than that direction. So finally, 0. So finally, E comes out to be 0. If EMF comes out to be 0, then see how simple the circuit becomes now again. What it becomes here?
Just one resistance, sir.
Just 4 volt. And here one resistance, and that resistance is equal to 2 by 4. That is 1 by 2 ohm. What is the current again? Current comes out to be same as before. No difference at all. 8 ampere. So again, current is 8 amperes. No, but don't think if this current is 8 ampere, then these currents will also be same. These may be different. These may be different because they have batteries. So some difference may be there in this circuit and the last circuit. If you want to find out what is current in this, then do one thing now. How to find? Take reference.
So symmetry, sir.
Wait a second. Take one side as reference. Let me finish. After that, if you want to give input, you give. Take one side. I follow the same method always. If we keep changing method, you may get confused. Zero one side, other side, 4 volt. So it will be 0, 0 everywhere, right? 0, 0, 0 here, up to this 0 only. And other side, 4 volt only. Now, minus plus. Minus plus, how much? 2 volt? So it will be plus 2 here. It will be plus 2 here. But in this, it will be minus 2 here. And here also, it will be minus 2 here. Now, which branch corresponds to which? Let us name number the branches. Branch number 1, branch number 2, branch number 3, branch number 4. Here, which is branch number 1 in our present case? 1 is pointing towards positive towards A. So this is 1. Second is, 4th is also pointing towards A, positive towards A, 4th. But 2nd and 3rd are other 2, 2nd and 3rd, like this. Now, in first branch and in second branch, currents will be same because they have identical situation. What is the current in the first and the second branch? And from which to which side it is going? It is 4 volt, 3, 2 volt. So it will be still A is at higher potential than B. It will be going in that direction. And the current in this branch will be, what it will be? What should I name it first? Let me name it as I1 is already I1, I2, I cannot say. So I will say I3. This side also, I 3. Okay. I am assuming the direction of current from A to B only. Here also A to B, let us call it I4. And in third branch also I4. Now, what is the value of I2? I2 will be, observe where is I2? I2 is in our first branch. Which side I have taken the direction of current? I have taken direction of current from A to B. So it is I2. Sorry, not I2. I3. I3. And I4. And I4. Can you tell me what is I2? I3? I3 will be 4 minus 2 divided by 2. Right?
So one,
4.
One,
huh?
1 ampere.
1 ampere, correct. It is 1 ampere. What is I4? I4 will be 4 minus of minus 2 divided by 2. See, observe here. 4 minus 2. So it is becoming how much? 3 amperes. Right?
Yes, sir. 3 amperes.
Then tell me, what is the value of I1 now? Apply KVL in the same node 1. What will be I1 now? What will be I1 now?
Minus 2.
I1 will become equal to the current entering is what is the current exiting?
8 entering, sir.
8 entering, 2 I3 leaving.
8 entering and I3, 2 I3 leaving and I1 also leaving. So what is 2 I3? 2 into 1 plus I1 and it is 8. So what is I1 equal to? 6. I1 is 6 ampere. Similarly, what is I2?
2, sir.
I4 is 6. This is 8. This is 1. I4 was 6 or 3?
3, sir.
I4 was 3. So 8 ampere going, 3 ampere coming, and also from above,
minus
1 ampere also coming. It is 3 plus, yes, minus 4. I2 is equal to minus 4 ampere this time. By KCL, directly I am writing. I2 is equal to minus 4 ampere by KCL. So, see how we will do. Now, how many modifications we can have here? Many, many modifications. Infinite modifications are possible. There is no limit also. Why? I can change the batteries. I can give different batteries, not just two. Or if I change the polarity of any one of these, then the situation will be completely different. Then we cannot trust. All the currents will be now different, including it may affect sometimes this I current also, this external current, which we were getting as 8. It will not be 8 in all the cases. It will become very much different if I change polarity of any one of these batteries. That also will be enough. Why? Because if I change the polarity of any one of these batteries, let us say I make it this way, plus 2. Then what it will become now, EMF? EMF will become now, I think, 2 by 2, 1 plus 1 plus 1 minus 1. That is 2. Now it will become 1 volt. If I change polarity of any one of these, then the EMF here will become effectively 1 volt.
Yes, sir.
So definitely, if it is becoming 1 volt, then the current will no more be as before. It will become different because now there will be 1 volt battery sitting here. If 1 volt battery is sitting here, then it may be 4 minus 1 upon 1 by 2, or it may become 4 plus 1. That depends how the polarity of the effective battery will be. Effective battery may be supporting the current or it may be opposing the current. If it is supporting, then it will become 4 plus 1, 5 upon 1 by 2. Okay, then the current may become 10 amperes. Or if it is opposing,
6 ampere.
Then it will become 6 ampere. So see, just by reversing polarity of any one of these, situation changes so much. Okay.
Sir, doubt, sir.
Yes, ask.
Sir, I2 can't flow, no, sir. Potential difference is equal 0.
No, again, boy, listen to my words carefully. in all the conducting wires the current is flowing. This is also a conductive wire. Current will flow in the conducting wires. Why it flows in the conducting wires? Because the resistance is negligible, not zero.
Okay.
This is at, or I can say this is at higher potential as compared to the other one, but these are nearly at same potential. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I explained this thing before also, and again you are having that doubt only. In the wires which carry zero resistance, they can carry current even if potential difference is also zero, because I is equal to V by R. If V is zero and R is also zero, it is zero by zero form. Zero by zero form is indeterminate, and that zero by zero form can give us in certain cases finite value, and we should not be surprised if we are getting finite current. Okay. Right. Any other thing which you want to ask? Any other question in this? No? Then let us take one more example. Next example I am taking with that case which I had taken before. These three essences are, let us say, looking like series, but just this conducting wire and this conducting wire will make him a lot of difference.
Parallel.
Now it is A, parallel. It is B. This A will come up to this.
Yeah.
So it is
A2.
A here.
Yes,
similarly, this B will be connected up to this.
B.
So it is, B here also. Now these are clearly in parallel. If they are in parallel, what is the effective resistance? R by 3.
R
that by part is simple. Let us now modify it slightly by giving batteries. And I will give batteries all in same direction. Same direction. EMFE. Question is, find potential difference between.
Sir, E only, sir.
Sir, only E, sir.
I told before.
A and B.
Only E, sir.
Potential difference will be between A and B. Will be.
You told, sir.
No, actually, I told already, but somebody asked me at that time. That's why I said, okay, I will say it again. What is the potential difference between A and B? Also, I will not just leave it up to that only. I will ask other questions also. What are the currents I1 and I2? What are the currents I1 and I2? Try to get these. If you want me to make it simple, then I'm giving you EMF as 2 volt and resistance as 1 ohm, just to make it simple. A and B. So how to do? First of all, these are in series, parallel. Take one end as A and other end as B. And in between connect these batteries. How to connect the batteries? Notice, one battery is towards A, other battery is towards positive terminal towards B. Third battery has positive terminal towards A. Two batteries have positive terminal towards A. This is a common mistake. Students will think that they are all in the same direction. So here also I should make them all in same direction. Not like that. Here you observe. Plus is towards A. Plus is towards B. So one of these batteries will have plus towards, positive towards B. 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2. Then equivalent combination will be 1 by 3 and 2 volt. You can find it out by the formula. I'm just directly telling you now. After this, what is the potential difference between A and B? So potential difference between A and B, now it is an open circuit. If it is open circuit, no current flows in this. It was not open circuit here. There were some closed loops also. Some currents were flowing here, there. But overall effectively, A and B will be this cell is like an open cell only. It carries current internally, but not externally. Therefore, there will be no potential drop across 1/3. So the EMF will be just equal to potential difference.
2 volts.
That will be equal to just 2 only. If current flows and it goes away, then I told you already, I think, that potential difference is equal to E minus IR. Yeah. If current enters, then it is E plus IR. But when no current,
E when only.
No current, then it is just E only. E. So answer we obtained here. But other two questions are also there. What is I1? What is I2? Okay. To get I1 and I2, I will have to get these branch currents first. And I have to number the branches. So get ready to number 1, number 2, number 3. Which is number 1 here? Number 1 and number 2 are similar. But number 3 is different.
So number 1, number 3 is...
I did wrong here. Number 1 and number 3 are...
Number 2 as B negative.
Yes, that's right. Number 2 B is positive, correct. So number 2 is below. 1 and 2 are different and 3 is same. 1 and 3 are same. What is the branch current in 1 and 3? Now, very simple way to do this is... how to do? Wait a second. Let me think again. How to do? This is reference 0. Then this side it will be plus two, and this side it will be minus two. What is the potential at A? VA. Assume it to be VA. Do we know potential at A or not?
Yes, sir. 2, sir.
Actually, we know already. We know because we have already determined the equivalent. So we know VA minus VV0, I have assumed it is equal to 2. So VA is nothing but 2 volt. In case somebody forgets this step, then our KCL will still help us. How to do by KCL? VA minus 2 by 1 plus VA minus 2 by 1 plus VA minus of minus 2 by 1 is equal to 0. Let us do by that also, by KCL. VA minus 2 by 1 plus VA minus 2 by 1 plus VA minus of minus 2 means plus 2 by 1 is equal to, then we are getting 3 VA is equal to what? I am getting different answer this time. What happened? 2. So VA is equal to
2/3 is coming, sir.
2/3. There is something wrong here, but wait a second. I should get same answer by both ways. Minus two, plus two.
VA minus 0/1.
Which is VA minus 0/1?
A B potential ground, no sir. That means a B zero, no sir. But directly VA minus 0 equals 2, no.
0 we cannot take because in between battery is connected. It is 0, but here it is 2.
Yes, sir. But directly VA minus VP is 2 means VB 0, no sir. VA equals 2, no.
What are you saying? VB is 0, so VA is equal to? We are getting VA as 2/3. what is our other method? Other method was net EMF divided by net resistance.
Sir, loop
which is, so if you do the 2/3
if we do what?
E net by R net equal to sigma E by R.
By that also we are getting that only?
2/3, sir.
E net by R net is equal to sigma EI by RI. By that we are getting, let us check once what we are getting. 2 divided by
6.
Not 2. This is unknown. E net is okay. E net is unknown. R net is 1/3. Now 2/1 plus 2/1 minus 2/1, which is equal to 2/1. Yes, it means I was writing it wrong. It is not 2. Net EMF itself is 2/3. So by both methods, we should get same result. 2/3 only. 2/3 only.
So if all EMFs are positive, negative, same means E net.
If all are in positive side only, then we will be getting 2.
E net equal to E, sir. But here, one is negative potential. You may change it.
One is negative, so one will be taken with minus sign here. That I committed this mistake here, and I just wrote it as 2. It is not 2. Final EMF is coming out here as 2/3. Equivalent EMF is 2/3. So both ways we are getting same result. VA is 2/3. VA is 2/3. Okay. Anyway, question was, what is I1? I1 we can get by knowing the branch current which goes from A to B in second and third branch. I1 will be equal to sum of these two. So what is the branch current going in second branch and the third branch? I1 will be sum of these two. Let us call these as I4, I5, I6. So what is I1? I1 will be I5 plus I6. You got it? Why it is I5 plus I6? Observe here. I1 yes. Current is dividing, let us say, into two currents. One current is going from A to B in second branch. Another current is going from A to B in third branch. Second branch current I'm naming here as I5. Third branch current I'm naming as I6. What is I5 and I6? Now, VA minus 2/1 plus VA minus of minus 2/1. What is that then finally? VA is 2/3 minus 2 divided by 1 plus 2/3 minus of minus plus 2/1, which is equal to 4/3. I1 is what? 4/3 amperes. We are getting I1. I1 is coming out to be 4/3 amperes. Is it understood? Yes, or not? Yes. Can you get I2 yourself now? Can you get I2? I2 will be... I2 will be this current plus this current. That will be again, I think, 4/3 only again.
Yes, sir.
4/3 only.
4/3 only.
Right. So we are getting answers. So any, whatever complex network we have of, for example, let me give one more complex network. You know, unbalanced Wheatstone bridge. Now, I will not only give unbalanced Wheatstone bridge, but other than giving unbalanced Wheatstone bridge, I will also give you some batteries in between. One, two. If one resistance also, it is unbalanced only if I give batteries, then it is a different case altogether. 2 volt each. And this is, let us say, 4 volt. What are the currents in different branches? Is it very difficult question?
Yes, sir.
or simple? Tell me, what is your opinion?
Simple on KCL applying.
Very simple or average or difficult? Although according to the questions which were you faced in the mains examination, those were really too simple. As compared to those, it will also appear to be tough only. But it is too simple question again. It is very simple. If I ask you this question, let us say, I'm not asking you this question whether it is tough or not. I'm asking you another question. If I give you two equations, two linear equations, and I ask you find out the values of x and y, let us say ax plus 3x plus 4y is equal to 5, and similarly some 4x plus 5y is equal to 6. There are two equations I'm giving, and I'm asking you to find out the values of x and y. Can you find easily or not? Is it a tough question?
Easy only.
Here also we need how many equations only? Just two. Get this idea. This is 4 here. This is 0 here. How many unknowns are there? V1.
V1 and V2.
And how many equations we need for those? Two equations. So the question which is involving just two equations will never be tough, provided you know how to write KCL. So just for practice, so that you don't commit mistakes and you feel confident in such questions, let us write the equations. And after that, I will not solve those. Just write the equation only. Can you write the equation for node V1?
Write
for V1. Tell me what is it.
VA minus VB equal to 4.
Okay. One more problem is there actually. Why some students face difficulty in such questions? Let me tell you reason why. It is not that don't know KCL. They know KCL. But when they see batteries, they start thinking that I have to apply some series or parallel combination formula of the batteries. But here it is not valid because it is neither series nor parallel. So don't waste time in doing that. Whenever you are not able to apply those formulas, directly use the basics. So we will do it now. For example, let us check whether this boy said right or not. V1 plus 2, I will assume outgoing current. So V1 plus 2 minus 4. V1 plus 2 minus 4 divided by 1 plus this side outgoing current.
V1
it is V2. What is it here? This side it will be V2 plus 2. So what will be the potential difference? V1 minus V2 plus 2 upon 1. Again, last one. V1 minus 0. V1 minus 0 divided by 1 is equal to 0. So now let us see whether 3V1 minus V2 is equal to
4.
4.
Yes, sir.
That is our first equation. Similarly, we can write the second equation also. Can you write the second equation? What is the second?
3VB minus VA equal to 2.
V2 plus, here it is V2 plus 2, here also V2 plus 2. But here it is V2 minus 2. So we are getting V2 plus 2, minus. V2 plus 2 minus 4 divided by 1 plus V2 plus 2 minus V1 divided by 1 plus V2 minus 2 divided by 2 is equal to 0. V2, we are getting now 2 plus 1 by 2 is 5 by 2. 5 V2 by 1, 5 V2 by 2, this minus V1 equals 2 minus 4 minus 2 plus 2 equals 1, I think. Right or not?
One only.
So we are getting both. If we know V1 and V2, after knowing V1 and V2, if I ask you any question of any current, can you not tell me? Can you not tell what is the net current flowing through 4 volt battery? We can tell or not? What is the current flowing through the 4 volt battery? We can tell easily.
By applying KCL at source.
Yes. And I can ask some other complicated looking questions. For example, I may ask you, what is the power dissipated in 1 ohm? Now you may think that normally in such cases, we find out the currents, or currents are also tough to find, then how to find power. But remember, if current is known, then power is known. Power is known at that instant only, or directly V1 we know, 0 we know, so V square by
R.
We can get such questions very simple. What is the power supplied by 4 volt battery? Power supplied by 4 volt battery will be, again simple, 4 into I, whatever I we are getting here. But how to get this current I? This current we will get by knowing these two branch currents first. Must we know these two branch currents? Then I will be sum of these two currents. Okay?
Okay.
This is how we do such questions. One more thing I would like to say here. How much time is the class? It is up to 9:30. Somebody is asking me how much time is the class. I will take up to 9:30 and then after that you do your work.
Okay.
So let me discuss maybe Thevenin's theorem. Can I discuss or not? I can discuss. Theorem of reciprocity also I can discuss.
Sir, infinity ladder.
Infinite ladder, I will discuss that also. I will discuss. But where for that? Let me discuss some theorem. One is Thevenin's theorem. And if I have a complex network having large number of voltages, batteries, or resistances connected in some complicated fashion with no symmetry at all, however difficult it may be, like this maybe, and maybe this one, it is also this one, that's neither series nor parallel, some complicated fashion they are connected. But if you take any two terminals from that, let us say I'm taking terminals AB, then this entire network can always, remember, always, it can always be replaced by a single equivalent. It can always be replaced by a single equivalent battery and single equivalent resistance. We call that equivalent as Thevenin's resistance. And we call the equivalent EMF as Thevenin's EMF. This will be AB. So this entire complicated circuit inside the box can be replaced by just a very simple ETH and RTH. For example, if somebody is giving me what is this current flowing through this resistance R. So all I need to do is, I need to somehow find out this RTH and I need to find out this ETH. Once I am done with that, then I will find out easily what is the current flowing through R. Current flowing through R will be equal to this is equivalent to this part here. R is external. Here also R is external. So current flowing is simply E Thevenin upon RTH plus R. Now, main question remains that how to get this ETH and how to get this RTH? Because it is clear, once we know ETH and RTH, then definitely we can get the current. But how to get that ETH in the first place? So, there is a method to obtain ETH. What we do? ETH, the Thevenin's EMF, is nothing but open circuit voltage. What is this? Open circuit voltage. What is meaning of open circuit voltage? The voltage appearing VOC is open circuit voltage. It is potential difference it is potential difference across AB when R tends to infinity. If R is infinity, then that is called as open circuit. You know that or not? If R is infinity, we call it as,
sir, current passing is
open
zero.
Circuit. Current passing becomes zero. Yes.
Zero.
Through external, externally it will become zero. That is this. Now, how to find out RTH? RTH is nothing but RTH is nothing but ETH divided by ISC. What is meaning of ISC? ISC is short circuit current. What is meaning of short circuit current? Means current when R tends to zero. The current which flows in R, current flowing through R when R tends to zero. Current through R when R tends to zero. That is called as short circuit current. Means if I connect A and B, if I connect A and B directly by a conducting wire and I measure the current, or I can do one thing here. If I want to do it experimentally, let us say I'm not interested to find out by calculation, but I want to find out by experiment, by conducting some experiment. Then it is so simple. What I need to do?
Voltmeter.
I will connect voltmeter first, then I will get the voltage, and next time I will connect ammeter and I will get the current.
Correct.
And after knowing the voltmeter voltage, that will be equal to ETH, and the current will be equal to ISC, and then I will divide ETH by ISC, and I will get corresponding RTH. And once I know RTH, then whatever resistance you give me, I can always determine what is the current flowing through that resistance. Okay, this is called as Thevenin's theorem. Thevenin found it, proved it for the first time probably. That's why we call it as Thevenin's theorem. Is it useful? I think mostly not that much, but we should know.
Because
sometimes if somebody, gives me some question directly based on this concept, we should be able to answer. But if you think that I will use it for circuit solving, I think probably we never need it for circuit solving. Reason, if somebody can solve this circuit and then get the equivalent EMF across this, it means he can already solve the circuit. After that, he can get ETH, right or not? So in order to get the ETH value also, he has to first solve the entire circuit. Therefore, what is the point of learning it to solve the circuits? This is not useful to solve circuits, but it is useful sometimes if the direct question based on this is asked. For example, they may give this thing that this is some complicated network. They are not even giving us what are the voltages, but they are saying, I connected voltmeter across it and I found the reading to be 5 volt. Next time I connected ammeter across it and I threw it, current flows to be 1 ampere. Then they are asking that if I connect 2 ohm resistance, what will be current flowing through this? Then if you know Thevenin's theorem, we can answer it, otherwise not. So that way it is useful. Okay, but don't try to solve this circuit using the Thevenin's theorem. We don't need that thing. Circuit we can always solve by simple our method, taking reference, using KCL. That method will always work. Is it okay?
Yes,
all right. Now one theorem is Norton theorem, but I think I will not take that. For that you need to know something called as ideal current source. You remind me, I will discuss ideal current source also. Ideal current source. Maybe I can discuss now only when I said I can discuss here itself. Ideal voltage source is cell. Ideal voltage source, or we can call simply ideal cell. What is ideal cell?
Ideal internal cell resistance is cell, zero, sir.
Yes, which has internal resistance zero. That is called as ideal cell. But current source is having infinite, just opposite, infinite internal resistance. It has infinite internal resistance, and ideal voltage source has zero internal resistance. this ideal current source has property that if it is ideal current source of 2 ampere current, let us say it is ideal current source of 2 ampere current, then connect it across any resistance. If you connect it across 2 ohm resistance, then also it will make 2 ampere pass through it. If you connect it across 2000 ohm resistance, then also what current it will make it pass through it?
2 ampere only.
It keeps the current fixed, and ideal voltage source keeps the EMF fixed. We know EMF will not remain fixed if it has some internal resistance. Why it will not be fixed then? Potential difference across the battery will not be fixed if we have internal resistance. Reason is
current will change.
Current will change, and if current changes, then E minus IR will be potential difference, VA minus VB, and that will be depending upon what is the current. So potential difference always will not be equal to the EMF. But if R is suppose zero, then potential difference will always be equal to EMF. So ideal voltage source gives us always constant potential difference, which is equal to its EMF also. And ideal current source always gives us constant current, which is equal to the value of that current source. What current it carries, it depends on that. Okay, right. So you know what is ideal current source and you know what is ideal voltage source. Normally, in your classes 11th and 12th, it is very rare that they will ask questions based on current source. But they will in mains, they may ask it sometimes. We don't know, because in mains, they themselves also don't know which question they are asking. So they may ask this question also of ideal current source. So you should know what it is. Okay. All right. Next, we can take one. I can take, I think, theorem of reciprocity. Theorem of reciprocity. That theorem says wait a second. Because I already explained you, I am changing it again. Norton's theorem I can take, because now I already told you the current source properties. Norton's theorem says that the way Thevenin's theorem says, what Thevenin's theorem says? Thevenin's theorem says that any circuit can be replaced by ETH and RTH, and that can be connected through our external resistance. So this is what our Thevenin's theorem says. But the Norton's theorem says that similarly, I can replace any circuit by ideal current source, and in parallel with what they call it, Norton's resistance. I don't know. I'm not sure about it. May they call it Norton's resistance or not? But okay, maybe I'm calling it as Norton's resistance. That may be done. Okay, that may be done here. This is the equivalent diagram of the same network which I have given above. So this can always be converted into this ideal current source. But in ideal current source cases, the resistance has to be connected in parallel. And in ideal voltage source, series, the resistance has to be connected in series. We can always convert into any circuit into this form, equivalent this form, and any circuit into equivalent this form, we can convert. And what is the relation between these? The relation is there. What was the short circuit current here? Short circuit current was ETH upon
RTH.
So same short circuit current will remain here also. But if I short circuit here, if I make R zero here, then what current will flow through this? Nothing will flow through R. The whole current will flow through this. Means whatever is the magnitude of this current source, this is nothing but short circuit current. Whatever is the magnitude of this current, this will be equal to here, this Norton's current or this short circuit current, it will be ETH by RTH. That will be the value of this current source. Now somebody may ask me, what is the value of Rn? How to find out Rn value? Rn I can find out by taking open circuit. If I take R as infinity, if I take R as infinity, what is the potential difference across AB?
Zero.
VOC. How it will be zero? What are you even talking about?
It's not zero, sir.
I make it like this, what current flows through? What current flows through this? It will always be I only fixed current, but I into Rn will be the voltage drop here, right or not?
Yes, sir.
Isc into Rn will be equal to what? Will be equal to Eth. So what is Isc? Isc was Eth divided by Rth into Rn. Then what is this Norton's resistance equivalent to? This Norton resistance comes out to be equivalent to same as Thevenin's resistance, right or not? Yes. This will come out to be same as Thevenin's resistance. Okay. Open circuit means when R is infinity. How did we get it? Just by comparing in open circuit, whatever voltage we obtain here, same voltage we should obtain here. Similarly, in short circuit, whatever current we obtain here, same current we should obtain here. By that comparison, we are able to find out the value of current source, and we are able to find out the value of resistance connected in parallel. Okay?
Sir.
I'm ending it now, and I will take day after tomorrow, I will take remaining topics. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye. Tomorrow no class.